All right, we're going to do a couple of things in this video. First, I'm going to introduce Firebug. Firebug is a way for inspecting the CSS and JavaScript, and it's very useful. It's available for Firefox. I also want to cover this idea of inheritance in the DOM. So when we apply CSS properties by selecting something, some element, whatever property we apply to that element also trickles down to all of the children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren. So we want to cover those two ideas. So first, Firebug. One of the useful tools in Firebug is this inspector, which allows us to inspect various elements. So when I click on that, it opens up down here in two panes. On the left-hand side is the HTML, and the right-hand side is the CSS. Here you'll see that the HTML is not actually as I typed it. It has been parsed by the browser and then re-presented here in a way that makes it very easy to see who the parents are and who the children and siblings are. So it's very easy to see that this H1 has body as a parent and this body has HTML as a parent. And likewise, there's these little pluses and minuses that let you hide parts of it so it's clearer and easier to see. In this case, you'll see that it also tells us what the styles are that we've applied to this particular element. So if we apply something, let's choose another element. We'll choose the div that we created, what people say. Note that if I put my cursor down here over that div, up above it highlights where that div is. Again, very useful. And if you look over here, the only property we have applied here is we've changed the color to green. So that should trickle down to all of the children. Let's open this up to see the children. It should apply to everything in the P and then everything also in this unordered list. So it should basically be trickling all the way down. So the question is, why is this blue and why is this red? This is blue because the A tag by default is blue. It's a property that's kind of built into the A tag. We can change that. We can select the A tag and change it to another color. But by default, the A is going to be kind of obstreperous. That's not what I want to say. A child who's rebellious, there we go, and is rebelling against the parent and not accepting the property that the parent has left to them. Another case here is the red one, which we, if you'll recall, let's find it. It's class red, so let's go ahead and take a look at that one. Here we've assigned it a color red. That is, we have another rule that kind of is contrary to the inheritance rule. And when two rules argue, if the inheritance loses, right? So you can see here in Firebug, it's actually lined out to the color green, which otherwise would have been inherited, and is applying the color red. This is a very simple case. We could go instead to a slightly more complicated case, here's my blog. And so here we have many, many more layers and layers and layers of children and parents because it's a more complicated site. So as you can see, it goes fairly deep in terms of the string. Let's go ahead and inspect something, say, over here in the tweet lists. We'll look at this one right here. So it highlights where that is in the HTML. And it tells us that, yes, we've assigned something to the any of the A's, that is the anchors, that are on the in the section that is called aside. We'll make them gray. So there's something and that we've applied, and you'll see that there's some other things that have been applied to this section just because it's an A. And then you'll see that it's also inherited things from the LI. Where's the LI list item? It's right above it. And then it's also gotten some things from the UL, which is right above that. And then you'll see that it just keeps on going and going and really inherits a lot of stuff going all the way up to HTML, all the way up this tree to the great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandparents that pass things along. So this can be very convenient because you can assign something to a whole page by putting it in HTML, but it's also important to know that you can then make exceptions to that in some of the children. And so that whole process is deciding how far you want your property to travel, I guess.